What's up, YouTube? GeoMan from Rad Titan here, co-creator and AT, co-creator behind Cool Beans. We're doing the review of the Prometheus Engineer statue by Sideshow Collectibles. We just had a debate, it's exclusive, obviously. We just did a debate. If anybody doesn't realise yet, we are taking a piss when we do that, obviously, so please don't red arrow us because of that, because it's a joke. We were just talking about whether this was a premium format, a commie kit, or such and such. We've looked everywhere and we can't find out. Apparently, it is just labelled Prometheus statue.
It is 1/5 scale, so it might be a commie kit.
Well, yeah, it's not labelled as such. We think it is 1/5 scale. It is 1/5 scale, so that's great. Alex has the exclusive. He's got a great story about that. I'm not even going to try and get into it because he'll just say, shut up, that's my story. So I'm not even going to go there. We learned our lessons from the last time I tried that. The box is lovely.
You were sulking throughout that whole video as well.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Don't like being cut off. And it's funny because I like cutting people off loads. Anyway, I've got the box here. It's really nice. It's a limited edition of really low run.
Very low.
It's number 83 of 200. And apparently the regular is only 500.
So it's only 500 and there's still a few left on Sideshow website.
Yeah. Well, if you see this, I'm really looking forward to this because a lot of things and... You know, we watched recently Too Many Figures, Brian. What's up, brother?
Yep.
He just did a repaint of it and it looks fantastic. So
I know, I've got to say, his Apocalypse looks amazing.
Yeah, it looks really good, doesn't it? Needs to stop doing that.
Also, the just going by the Sideshow QC issue here, and they've nicely put the exclusive sticker upside down.
It's like, yeah, you've got an exclusive. Just well be done. Happy. Just be happy. Yeah,
just be happy. But
stop complaining. I usually, because I was promoted recently, and I usually get... box and base, but as this comes in one fixed unit,
yep,
I just get box.
No,
box
no, no, nice. You're going to grab the exclusive.
Oh, I get the exclusive. Do I get commander?
Yeah, go grab it. So yeah, because the base is actually fixed to the statue, which we'll show soon. We'll give George the X part. So just stick if you put it down.
Yeah.
Just otherwise you're going to
break it. Yeah.
No, no, no. Well, you can buy it and break it. So this is the space jockey head. And this is the piece that comes with it. This is the additional part. And when initially I got the T-800 Battle Damage, and I was lucky enough to get the exclusive on that as well. But that came with the thumbs up and coming out of the lava. And when I got that, I wasn't too impressed with that.
What's this?
And I was kind of thinking quite lowly, low of the blue, isn't it?
I don't know.
Oh, shit.
I don't want to touch that. What is that?
All right, I'll have a look in a minute. Well, there's something hanging off my thing now.
What's that bit? What's that? I don't want to touch that. I don't know if that's
keep going around.
I don't know if that's a bit. Anyway, so...
I mean, I was quite disappointed with the T-800 one. And looking at this one, I do actually really like this. And BMR wanted to see what the base looked like, so the exclusive looked like. So this is a shout-out to BMR. Hope you decide to get it, Brian.
Mark Riddle. Peace!
You know, I hope this has helped you decide there.
It's got some really cool cracks in it. I love the glossiness of the eyes. It's fantastic. It's really nice. It's much better than the Terminator one.
Oh, it is.
One.
I mean...
Terminator we'll one's kind of bad.
Really shit. We'll have to cut that off now because, I mean, this is just the additional part. And obviously, we've got the whole statue to do. So, if we're going to take this down and get the statue out. So.
Cool.
Everybody. Alex. And
Yeah. Yeah.
Go back and do that again.
No, we're right.
There we go. Alrighty. So basically, this is my engineer, and I'm really happy with it. Crisis over. That was only like a little bit of paper stuck on the back of the helmet, so we took that off. Basically, this is the engineer, and he's actually attached to his base, which is quite. I don't know many other pieces that do that. And you know, there's the bottom of that, number 83 of 200.
Really.
And the cool thing. Just put this straight down, and you know, I really like this piece. I think the paintwork's really nice. There's complaints about the sort of paintwork on the actual suit being a bit flat. I think I'm quite fortunate with this, where my one isn't that flat.
I don't think it's flat.
It looks quite good,
no.
But I mean, obviously, where these are hand painted, you can get some which are a lot better than others.
Very.
I had a regular and an exclusive Spider-Man.
J. Scott Campbell.
J. Scott Campbell. And I traded my exclusive for a Lord of Darkness exclusive, which was some really crazy deal, and I don't even know why the guy done it, but cheers, Jeremy Campbell, thanks for that. great deal on there. And, you know, the paintwork on both of those were very, very different, actually. When you looked at them together, the blues were very different, the reds were very different. So,
well, they are all hand-painted, aren't they, mate?
So, I mean, maybe some people get, like, a flatter version, or maybe I'm less, more tolerant to it, I don't know. So we come here, a lot of people also complain about, they say his hand looks very awkward, looks like he's got cramp in his hand.
I don't know.
It looks like he's going to, about to do something, maybe make a fist or something, I don't know. But
swear, maybe he's...
The thing I don't like about this piece is the...
join.
The join on the legs and the thighs.
It's just a bit fucking lazy, that, isn't it?
It's lazy, sort of sculpt on that.
Should have just literally just separated the man. It's just a shame because... And this ain't cheap, bro. This is, what, like $400 on the website?
It's $450
ones. Yeah, that's big money, brother.
I was quite fortunate with this one. So we're going to say about the story about how I got it. My girlfriend was going to buy me a piece and... She was going to buy me the Hellraiser piece, and then I literally thought, well, that's not going to be out for a little while. I wanted a piece sort of now and then because I'm like a little child. And someone was selling it, Arif Rot, Rotten Collector, he was selling his. It was all on pre-order, so I took over his pre-order, and it all went smoothly. You know,
nice.
Took it over, paid cost for it, and, you know, very, very happy with it.
That's so, a win, man. For an X as well, that's pretty cool.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So, I mean, this video, I mean... you know, Arif wanted to see what it was like, and you know, hopefully he's not too disappointed.
I think this has got a nice glossy shine on the paintwork on the body. I don't think you can call that flat at all.
What I'm going to do is I'm just going to do an up and down, and then I'm going to actually I'm going to turn it off and turn the camera back on because I can't turn my light off without actually turning the camera off. So bear with me a second, so I can just do that because the face is too bright. So I've just turned the camera off, so hopefully you can sort of still see all the details. I'm just going to go run up here. This is the base, as I say. It's a very narrow base.
Good,
quite plain, but it's, it's very easy to display and, you know, work our way up at the hand, sort of his chest piece, so you can pick up on the detail there a lot nicer now.
I think it's great.
Lights off. And then there's his face. So, you know, it does actually look really pale on here, and I don't know if you can... make out, but there is a little bit more details, a bit more colours, a little
it's
bit
pinks and,
sort of pinks and purples around his eyes.
Around
his face, and if we just give it a little turn around, and you can see his outfit there. So, like, nice
outfit,
yes, goes out partying in that one, you know. And
that's where the join is really, really obvious in here and here. Just lazy, that lazy, it's just a shame.
So I think I saw this one first of all on Amber Racy's video.
Yeah, she does.
And she's got loads of ridiculous stuff. I mean, she's got like stuff all over the place, loads of pieces.
My wife was the same.
Yeah.
What a win that would be, eh?
Well, you'd be competing about which piece you get.
Yeah, but we'd all have them all.
Yeah.
It's like just being married to you.
Yes. Anyway. So, as I say, great piece. And as I say, hope, BMR, you know, this helps you make up your decision, and as I say, Brian, good paint job on yours, and Arif, thanks for letting me take over your pre-order.
The white fades up into the colour into his hands there. I mean, if you look from the side, you can see it from this one as well. I actually think the paintwork on this is really good. I think the sculpt's good. But it's so easy to display. It's around about 20 inches tall, 19-20 inches tall.
I think it's a bit taller actually. If we do,
yeah,
got the tape measure there. I mean, very.
From base, it's much taller than that. I'm
it's about 22, isn't it? 21 and a half?
22 inches. I think 22 inches is what you're going to need.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think the camera does this much justice on this one, but I do really like this piece, and I do highly recommend it. And I think in future, this piece is just going to go up in value and definitely be a piece which people are going to kick themselves for not getting, especially if you're an alien or a Predator collector.
Because the base is narrow, so, I mean, it only takes up vertical space. You can get this in a Detolf, no problem. You can get this anywhere.
Yeah.
It'll fit anywhere. And the great thing about it is, I mean, you can say, this is a little bit sloppy, the joins, and you can say that the pose is very, very static. But at the end of the day, if you think about the engineer as a whole, this is pretty much... I mean, people do say... that the face sculpt is of the gentleman at the beginning who takes the fluid and then his DNA breaks up and he falls into the water. They say that's the face and this is the body. I've got to be honest, having seen the film and seen this recently, I don't agree. I think that is the engineer. That's when that does look like him.
He's about to like bitch slap Guy Pearce.
Well, yeah, 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 when he's about to lose his rag. I mean, he definitely looks like the engineer. I mean, it's very good likeness, very good paint job for me. I think, Alex, you've got a good one. Really nice.
All right, guys. Thanks. Like, subscribe. Same as usual business. Take care, guys.
Yo, YouTube. No, I'll still do it.